What if Galen Marek killed Rahm Kota? If Galen Marek killed Rahm Kota, everything will progress the same way it did in the original timeline. But it will all change until Galen Marek is betrayed. Recovering from his fatal wound, Galen Marek would decide that it's the Sith who's hindering him from his destiny. He would return to the Jedi Temple on Coruscant and face the Jedi Trials. After destroying the Imperial troops stationed in the Jedi Halls, Galen Marek will face his true test. Ancient Dark Lord of the Sith, Darth Phobos. The battle of the two ensued. Darth Phobos taunted the young apprentice, telling him his fear is intoxicating. Though still in deep pain, Galen Marek channeled his fear into the power of the dark side. After minutes of battle, truly he and Darth Phobos went blade locked. But when Darth Phobos attempted a strike at Galen's head, he quickly dodged the strike. Force jumped in the air with seemingly lightning speed, and Force repulsed in the air, sending Darth Phobos crashing through multiple large bookcases. It was quite a scene. The young apprentice never unleashed a power so significant. Then used telekinesis to stack on 5 large bookcases on her body, crushing her bones, finally sending a shockwave that completely demolished her. 501st Stormtrooper commanders would suddenly arrive, a group of 20 directly shooting at Galen. He would deflect every single shot with relative ease, and force lightning them into oblivion. Passing through the large halls of the Jedi Temple corridors, he felt that the Jedi were weak and that the Sith was his enemy. He was interested in the plot of the rebellion. Would this rebellion trust him? Would this rebellion respect him? On Yavin 4, Galen Marek would approach a group of 4 rebel vanguards. They would ask, "Are you a Jedi?" Galen Marek would say, "I am no Jedi." The vanguards looking confused. In seconds, Galen Marek would be close to them, and their HH-15 projective launchers would fall to the ground immediately. The sudden attack caused a few hundred rebel soldiers to appear instantly. After a few minutes of battle, the vast majority of them would be defeated. Only a few would survive. He would see a young princess and her father escaping into the Tantive Ivy. Galen would try to use the power of the Force to pull back the Tantive Ivy. The father and daughter were escaping to their home planet of Alderaan. Bail Organa was going to contact an old friend, now known as Ben Kenobi. Suddenly, from behind, a lightsaber sliced through his outstretched arm. It was the perfect timing. It was the lightsaber of Ahsoka Tano. Galen Marek, disadvantaged and in shock, quickly escalated into immense anger and hatred. Ahsoka put it up a very good fight. Galen needed to use Gemso to ensure that not only he could survive, he could also defend himself so that he could possibly gain the upper hand. Ahsoka felt a presence arrive, Juno Eclipse and Proxy. Galen barely knew them. They told Galen that the Empire is the enemy and not the Rebellion. Galen thought that they worked for the Empire. Ahsoka was starting to lose the fight. She was more on the defense, barely catching up with Galen. Her defense was weakening. Juno's voice was tempting to Galen, but that voice was insignificant to the power of the dark side. Ahsoka felt a burn on her side. With no control of the Force, he sent Ahsoka flying into the forest and Juno Eclipse well into the Yavin Temple. Running to Juno Eclipse, she passed away. Tears and remorse rolled down his face. He questioned, what did she ever do to him? There was a temporary pull to the light side of the Force. This was more than death. There was a surrounding dark, dark energy permeating. He heard the ancient spirit of Exar Kun. Exar Kun said, since the establishment of the Rule of Two, the Sith's lust for power has only increased. This was the first time Galen had encountered or spoke with an ancient Sith. Galen learned Exar Kun initially defeated the Masasi warriors by utilizing the power of the dark side. Exar Kun told Galen, in order to gain absolute control over the galaxy, Galen must destroy the Sith that are currently in power, and that could pose a threat against Galen's ascension to rule. He listened to the spirit of the Dark Lord of the Sith. From then, Galen would train to defeat Emperor Palpatine, the most powerful Dark Lord of the Sith in his era, and Palpatine's most powerful puppet, the Chosen One, once known as Anakin Skywalker, now known as Darth Vader. Galen's first step was to look for powerful bounty hunters. He found ex-Jedi Master A'Sharad Het. He was a very, very, very powerful Force user. His Force potential was near the Chosen One's. With these two Force users and ritualistic training, they stood a chance against Darth Vader and Emperor Palpatine. They decided they would destroy Darth Vader first. So, they would wait for the right time to destroy Darth Vader. And when the right time comes, they would prove victorious. So, I hope you all enjoy my Star Wars fan fiction.
Everything that's transpired in my fan fiction is from the expanded universe.
In the fan fiction, I made it so Galen would be absolutely corrupted by the dark side of the Force. Once Galen's eyes turn yellow, it signifies that he has immersed himself in absolute darkness. Juno would not be able to turn Galen back to the light side of the Force whatsoever, since they were pretty much strangers. Proxy would also have no say in Galen's allegiance to the Force. If Obi-Wan, who was the brotherly figure of Anakin Skywalker, was unable to turn Anakin back to the light side of the Force, how can a stupid droid turn Galen back to the light side of the Force? Galen, being essentially raised as a Sith slave, would make him want to seek vengeance against those who restricted him, and perpetuate him to seek absolute power no matter what endeavors he shall endure, or no matter how much pain he shall endure. Nothing will stop his quest for power. So, this is it for part 1 of What If Galen Marek Killed Rahm Kota fan fiction. I will be doing a part 2, so please stay tuned for the second part. And if you enjoyed my Star Wars fan fiction, please give a like, comment, and subscribe. Thanks for watching, and may the Force be with you. Always.